ప్రైజ్ ద లార్డ్
ప్రైజ్ ద లార్డ్
హల్లెలూయా
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 డియర్ బ్రదర్స్ అండ్ సిస్టర్స్ ఇన్ జీసస్ నేమ్ ఐ వెల్కమ్ యు ఆల్ వన్స్ అగైన్ టు దిస్ ఎపిసోడ్ ఆఫ్ థండర్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్ టుడే వి విల్ ప్రైజ్ అండ్ వర్షిప్ ద లార్డ్ ఫర్ ఎ మోమెంట్ వుడ్ యు ప్లీజ్ స్టాండ్ అప్ ఆన్ యువర్ ప్లేసెస్ అండ్ లెట్ us థ్యాంక్ ద లార్డ్ వి ప్రైజ్ అండ్ బ్లెస్ హిస్ నేమ్ బికాజ్ హీ ఇస్ ఎ మైటీ గాడ్ Lord, we bless you, we praise you, we glorify you, together with holy angels.
Spirit of God, come down. Spirit of God, rain down. Spirit of God, come into my life. Spirit of God, come down. Spirit of God, rain down, Spirit of God, come into my life. Spirit of God, rain down. Let your fire fall on me, oh Spirit of God. Fall, fall on me, Spirit, fall on me. I'll pray you rain down, down, rain down in my life, oh rain down. Rain down, Spirit of God, rain down, down, rain down in my life, oh, rain down, Spirit of God.
Spirit of the Lord, we pray in a very special way, in this fine evening, please come down into our hearts, enlighten our minds, let us be blessed in Jesus' name, and the power
of Spirit of God. Come down, Spirit of God, rain down, Spirit of God, come into my life, Spirit of God, rain down, let your fire fall on me, oh Spirit of God, fall, fall on me, Spirit, fall on me, I'll pray you rain down. Rain down in my life, oh, rain down, Spirit of God.
Let's raise the hands and let us praise and worship the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What an outpouring of the Holy Spirit.
Oh,
Holy Spirit,
rain
come
down
like
Holy
a rainbow
of
in your heart.
Holy
let
Spirit,
the heart be
rain down.
In the Spirit. The blessings
Holy
of the Holy Spirit,
rain down.
The fruits of the Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit of God, rain down.
Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit.
We welcome you, Holy Spirit of God. Move
holy,
in this
holy,
place,
holy,
holy,
holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, Spirit, come down like a dewfall onto each and every
Let your fire fall on me, oh Spirit of God. Fall, fall on me, Spirit, fall on me. Let your fire fall on me.
Let the fire come
me.
Down.
Oh, Spirit.
Let heaven be filled with the fire of the Holy Spirit.
Fall, fall
oh, Holy Spirit.
Me. Spirit,
oh, Holy Spirit.
Fall on me.
Touch us.
I'll pray
heal us.
Rain
deliver
down,
us.
Share down, rain down in my life. Oh, rain down. Rain down.
Let everyone who attends this service be filled with the Holy Spirit, with the holy fire. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah,
hallelujah. Spirit of God. Thank you, Lord, hallelujah.
Holy Spirit, we invoke your blessings. As we listen to the word of God, let the holy fire comes into our hearts so that we may be renewed and recreated. As the Holy Spirit transformed the apostles into courageous preachers of the word of God, we too pray, Lord, that the Holy Spirit touch and inspire us so that we may be able to live a worthy Christian life. Our Lord, give us the grace to renounce what you don't like, to uphold what you value the most. We pray this evening, let the Holy Spirit come down. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, today we are going to meditate on a particular topic. The topic is this: there are certain things which the God hates. Do you know what are the things that the God hates? The Word of God has clearly said there are 7 things that God hates. We know if you hate somebody, we cannot do any good to those people whom we hate. Therefore, the Word of God says many people today are not blessed because there are certain things which our Lord hates. And unless and until we get rid of these things, we cannot get the blessings from above. Praise the Lord.
Praise
Hallelujah.
The Lord. Hallelujah.
What are the 7 things that the Word of God says that God hates? Let us come into the book of Proverbs, chapter 6, verse 16 onwards.
There are 6 things the Lord hates, 7 that are detestable to Him: haughty eyes, a lying tongue, hands that shed innocent blood, a heart that devises wicked schemes, feet that are quick to rush into evil, a false witness who pours out lies, and a person who stirs up conflict in a community.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So there are 6 things plus 1, 7. Altogether, 7 things are there which our Lord hates. And the first one is haughty eyes. What does it mean? It means that, dear brothers and sisters, a person who is pride, who is a slave to pride, that person is a man who is hated by Jesus, God. Hallelujah. In whose heart the pride rules, a proud heart God does not accept. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
God always considers and blesses the humble and the lowly. Therefore, in the book of Proverbs, chapter 16, verse 5 says, God hates one who is haughty. Can you read that?
The Lord detests all the proud of heart. Be sure of this, they will not go unpunished.
Praise the Lord. The Word of God says, He does not like the wicked people, especially the haughty, and they will not pass without being punished. A person who has got so much pride in his heart, he cannot do good to others. He always considers others as somebody who are not worthy. And he feels that I am the only person who knows everything. And as a result, what happens? Dear brothers and sisters, he will never accept anybody. And he will always criticize things. He has always a feeling that whatever I say is true. And the Word of God says, God does not love, or God hates the proud-hearted, or the person who is having a haughty eye. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Again, when we come into the book of Jeremiah, chapter 50, verse 31 and 32.
I am against you, O arrogant one, says the Lord God of hosts, for your day has come, the time when I will punish you. The arrogant one shall stumble and fall.
The arrogant ones, which means the proud-hearted people will stumble and fall. So the Word of God says, one who is arrogant, one who is proud-hearted, who is having a haughty eye, is not acceptable before the Lord. Let's say hallelujah.
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 Then, second thing which God hates is, we see, a tongue that speaks lie. A person who speaks lie, that such people will not be accepted by God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Why God is always saying about this? Why God punishes? We know the Satan came into this world saying a big lie. We see in the first books of Genesis how he lied to Eve and made her to eat the fruit which was forbidden. And we know that was a disaster of the humankind. So lie is from Satan. We see in the Gospel of St. John, chapter 8, verse 44.
You belong to your father, the devil,
and you want to carry out your father's desire. He was a murderer from the beginning, not holding to the truth, for there is no truth in him.
There is no truth in him. Even a person, there is no truth, which, what does it mean? It automatically means he always lies. Therefore, the word of God says, I hate the liars. And again, when it comes to the another point also, it's the very same thing. One who gives false witnesses, that he's a person who is lying. We know these false witnesses cannot get blessing from heaven. There are so many people, even in courts, they give false witnesses in order to gain some money. Dear brothers and sisters, make sure that the tongue through which you speak is of a great value before the Lord. Therefore, in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 15, verse 19 says,
therefore, thus says the Lord, if you turn back, I will take you back, and you shall stand before me. If you utter what is precious and not what is worthless, you shall serve as my mouth.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The word of God says, if you utter what is not worthless, then your tongue shall become my mouth. When a person keeps his tongue and he doesn't speak deceitful things, he does not give false witnesses, and if he is true to what his word, then definitely he is going to get blessed. Again, the word of God says, those people who shed innocent blood, they are not acceptable to God. God hates such people. What does it mean? It means that, dear brothers and sisters, there are so many people today do shed innocent blood by doing abortions and by making people to fall into sin and leading them into different kinds of sins. Today, abortion is a very common thing in this world. And we may say in different names, we may give some pet names for that, whatever may be. God says, if it is an innocent blood you shed, and your family is going to be ruined. Again, all those feet that goes to sin. There are so many people who go after many people and things in order to commit sin. Such people are not acceptable to God. God hates the feet of those people who go for sin. Maybe some going to the adultery, or maybe for doing something else which is not acceptable to God. Such people will be punished. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Therefore, dear brothers and sisters, in the book of Psalms, chapter 119, verse 105 says,
your word is a lamp for my feet.
Your word is a lamp for my feet.
A light on my path.
A light on my path. When you go ahead, the word of God must show you a path. Which means a person who is accepting, a person who goes according to the word of God will never stumble. And the word of God says, all those whose feet are running towards committing sin will be punished. It is abomination to God himself. Hallelujah.
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 Therefore, again, last but not the least, the word of God says, those people who make controversy, who makes division among brothers and sisters. There are so many people who make division in the families. There are so many people who make division in the churches. There are so many people who make division among kingdoms. And such people, wherever division is spread, then the person is not acceptable to God. We know the serpent came in the beginning, the book of Genesis, and he just sowed the seed of division by accusing each other. Adam accused Eve, Eve accused snake, and there was a division started. And wherever there is division, such people or those who cause division will not be acceptable, because they are, God hates such people. Hallelujah.
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 Let's stand up. Let us raise the hands up to heaven. Let us praise and worship the Lord. Lord, wash my fantasies, my imaginations, my tongue, and every organ of mine. Let the precious blood of Jesus flow from top to bottom, so that I shall be purified once again. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh Lord, today we pray. Oh Lord, there are seven things which you would hate. Lord, give us the grace and courage and strength to remove all these stains from my heart. Let me be like you, Jesus.
Speak
nicely, never to say a lie. never to run after worldly pleasures, never to imagine and about to think deceitful things, never to give false testimony. Let us praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah,
glory, 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 glory. Thanks Jesus, praise Jesus, glorify you Lord. Come down Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Done in my life. Lord, I want to get away from the sinful situations. I want to surrender myself totally and fully to you, Lord Jesus. As I pray today, Lord, you know my difficulties. There are a lot of problems in my families. My family members are not cooperating with me. They are fighting each other. Many of my family members do not have faith in God. But I too cannot pray, Lord. I would like to pray, but I am unable to pray. Oh Lord, There are so many sick people in my family. My own sickness troubles me a lot. I need a healing, Lord. I need a healing touch from you, Lord. Oh Lord, there are financial crises in my life. I don't have a stable job. My business is getting worse and worse. There is no one to support me, Lord. Lord, you have said rightly, all those who weep are heavily burdened. All those who thirst, come to me. I will give you rest. And Lord, today we place ourselves before you, Lord. We have nothing to offer you except a sinful heart. We have nothing to give you, Lord, except my weaknesses and my shortcomings. Oh Lord, sometimes I feel that I am the cause of all these things. I feel that I am the cause of my agony in my family. I feel that my sins and my abominations are the reason for my misery. Lord, give me the grace. Give me the grace to worship you, to bless you, to raise your name up, and to be faithful to you. Dear brothers and sisters, let us dedicate ourselves totally to Jesus. Let us surrender ourselves, our weaknesses, our difficulties, our troubles, our sufferings. He is not far away from us. He is a living God. He was one among us. Therefore, he could understand the feelings of each and every one of us. Let us raise our hands up to heaven and let us call out the name of Jesus as we are going to receive the blessings. Let us praise and thank the Lord. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
You wish.